Hey, what's up, UC family? Josh here again, bringing you another cocktail class. As you can see, I'm in my backyard. Beautiful Portland, sunny afternoon. Got the kiddie pool popping off. Got the music blasting. And of course, bringing you live sports with some disc golf. All right, so now to the cocktail. With the sun out, breeze flowing, I thought we'd make a tasty, refreshing Paloma. Originally, Palomas are just tequila, lime juice, and some sort of grapefruit soda like Squirt, but I thought we'd ramp things up today with some fresh squeeze grapefruit juice. Now, this cocktail I'll be making in batches of two. So I'm gonna use a whole grapefruit, and I've got my industrial juicer here. If you don't have one of these, you can of course use one of the old school glass juicers that you find at your grandma's house. Now, grapefruits are big, but surprisingly, you don't get a lot of juice out of them. So I'm gonna have to use a whole grapefruit for these two cocktails. All right, and I'm gonna cut my lime. And again, I cut them into eighths. First, cut the ends off, cut them in half. Now, watch what I'm doing here. I'm gonna cut a slit down the middle. And you cut them into eighths. Last time we muddled, this time I'm gonna use a citrus squeezer. So I'm gonna bypass the cutting into eighths and just cut into halves. As you can see, I have my grapefruit squeezed. Hey. Nice amount of juice. I'm going to squeeze one whole lime into here in ratios of half a grapefruit, half a lime into this cocktail. Of course, I'm making one for me and one for my wife, who is behind the camera, much deserving. So I'm making two. Next, on to the tequila. Today I'll be using Luna Azul Blanco. Blanco meaning that it's not aged in oak at all, maybe 6 months at the most. Reposado, which I'm normally a Reposado only guy, is anywhere from 6 to 18 months aged in oak, where you'll see it starts to get a little bit of color, that golden color. And then añejo, which means aged, which is aged anywhere from 18 months to 3 years. There just on the market is a super añejo, which has been aged up to 5 years. So I'm gonna add about 4 ounces. I count to 2 per ounce. Just make it up as you go. Use a jigger if you'd like. And for this, with margaritas, you use a triple sec. Today I'm gonna use a blue agave nectar. And just depends on your sweetness level, how much you like. Again, play around with that. You add your ice. And then, again, it's a sour, so we're gonna be shaking it up. Got our cocktails all shook up, and back to why I put the slit into the middle of the lime. As you can see, now I have a nice slit in all 4 of my wedges. I can run this along the edge of the rim, put it into my salt, cayenne, and paprika mixture. I get a nice salt rim there. I'm gonna do that on both these. Hey! Just get a little bit on the edge. Add your ice. It's my backyard. I can spill if I want. And you might be able to see that I have a little bit of space on all around the whole cocktail shaker. that gives me the ability to just hit the side and it'll come right off. Pour it in. As you can see, measured to perfection. Salt wedges on the edge. Now me and my wife have some nice cocktails. Cheers. Hey, UC family, just wanted to remind you that Chef has put together a to-go program for food. He's put together a menu for not just food that you can reheat, but also take-home kits that you can make at home. He's going to be doing some instructional videos to show you how to make classics like the chopped sirloin and the razor clams. And don't forget that we are delivering wine. If you have any inquiries about availability or pricing, please just give me a holler and we'll deliver it to your house. So, love you, miss you. Hope you're well. Cheers.